We're not getting a full reveal trailer, but a tease for the next Smash Brothers character. Well, let's break down this Nintendo Direct lead. What's happening, my Blocked buddies, and welcome to a brand new episode of Blocked Content's Leak Speak. My name is Callum, and this is going to be your content for today. There is so much stuff to break down. I mean, it's fun to think about Smash Brothers Ultimate's Fighters Pass, the final three characters, and kind of think of Sakurai is going to pull us this crazy maneuver where it's going to be a character that no one expects. It's from some weird game that no one's ever played before. But yeah, there's also a very high chance that it's going to be these huge third-party characters. Well, what we have to today is something that we discuss a little bit of in between. And also, there is a lot of general Nintendo Direct information that we go through in today's episode. It's going to be a lot of fun, there's going to be a lot to break down, there's going to be a lot of information, and generally just a lot of fun stuff that pertains to franchises like Dragon Ball Z, the Metroid franchise. There's a lot on the new Metroid Prime trilogy that a lot of people have been, of course, very eagerly awaiting. There's info on new Pokemon Snap, as well as other third-party developers that have a lot of different games that they're bringing to the Nintendo Switch. But what I think is even more awesome is that there is a trailer for a new Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Fighter, which would be Fighter 4 from Fighter Pass number 2. And it's from a franchise that I am not too familiar with, so I had to dive right into all that information and kind of find out for myself what is this franchise. But supposedly it's not going to be a full reveal of the character, kind of like what we had with ARMS. So if this leak is to be believed, we are just going to hear the franchise and then hear about the character later, which, yeah, it already happened with the ARMS situation, and then of course in other situations we kind of knew a character was coming, we just didn't know what franchise. So there is so much stuff to break down here. Get seated, grab yourselves a snack or some popcorn. It's going to be a whole fun Blocked Content episode. And of course, I've been answering many of you guys' questions about Super Smash Bros. Ultimate and New Fighters in our show Question Blocked, where I answer your questions. What do I think of your favorite game? How do you start making YouTube content? Whatever you can think of, send your question through to blockedcontentmail@gmail.com, and I will answer your question live on the show in our next Question Blocked episode. So let's just break down what all this information is, because it is a lot. It says, Nintendo Direct Leak. Hello, here are the upcoming announcements. It opens with a trailer for Apex Legends, which releases immediately after the direct presentation. Then Plants vs. Zombies Battle for Neighborville and Complete Edition. Then The Sims 2, and then a trailer for new Pokemon Snap. Then Smash Brothers news, right? Trailer. Teaser for the Smash Brothers Ultimate Fighter 4 from Fighters Pass number 2. A character from Buddy Mission Bond. The reveal will be in the near future. Then a mid-break, whoever the host will be, then reveals the Nintendo 3D Switch. Face tracking 3D, also touchscreen that can sense how close your fingers hover over the screen, meaning you can touch or interact with the 3D that sticks out, which is really cool. And then Doom Eternal and a select library of Switch games will get 3D updates, and in certain cases, because it's more powerful, will run at 60 frames per second now. So yes, a Nintendo 3D Switch, which is totally crazy. Then Star Wars Clone Forces Team Ninja, pretty much the same that Ultimate Alliance was, but with the Rebels and Clone Wars style, exclusive to the Nintendo Switch. And then a Mad Max port, and a new Dead or Alive version exclusive for the Nintendo Switch, which would be really cool, Ryu Hayabusa and my girl Kasumi, right? Very awesome. Then, Dragon Ball Z Kakarot is getting a Nintendo Switch port, and No Man's Sky is also getting a port on the Nintendo Switch. Then it says, one last thing, Metroid Prime Federation missions, next level games, not chibi characters anymore. And then one last thing, Metroid Prime Trilogy is available for a limited time right after the presentation. So much information is contained in this leak, and generally just all the Super Smash Bros. News here is astounding. Like, it's pretty crazy to think about the fact that we are going to be getting another teaser where it's not even a franchise that a lot of people are very known with, right? This is a Tecmo Koei thing, and of course it's from the same creator that also does One Punch Man, so from that corner of the world, a lot of people will know. But like, if I were to go to a random, you know, game fanatic or game lover and say, yeah, Buddy Mission Bond is coming to the Nintendo Switch to Smash Brothers, and they're like, Buddy Mission, Buddy what? James Bond? No. What is this? So, yeah, people are going to have to dive into all that information and kind of find out. And of course, as was the case with Min Min, it probably is very seriously, very quickly available what character this will be, right? I mean, with Min Min, it was just the only choice, right? A lot of people were saying it could maybe be Ninjara, or it could still be characters that are already in the game, like Spring Man. And of course, Ribbon Girl was a costume. But no, Min Min was of course the front runner there, and it became Min Min. So for this franchise, it would probably also be a little bit of the same. Now what I think is cool, Apex Legends, of course, a game that people have been looking forward to, you know, Switch style for a very long time. I think generally just these types of games have been doing it really well this past year and the year before, that Nintendo is just looking to cash on it, right? And I think that it would be really cool to have a Nintendo styled of one of those games, right? Where you just essentially are Smash Brothers characters or Nintendo characters in general. Maybe for a franchise like Metroid, it would make a lot of sense just to have a lot of people, you know, drop down on a planet and then just go at each other. I even think that the franchise for Kid Icarus would really fit very well with it. If you look at the, you know, the multiplayer styles that are in Kid Icarus Uprising, then it would even kind of feel like one of those games. Like, oh, where are we dropping, Pit? Right? Make all the jokes that you want. So I think it's really cool that we're also getting potentially more Metroid news, Metroid Prime Federation missions, which feels like something to make up for Federation 4. I think it's going to be fun to see those characters in a not chibi form. And then how will it connect to Metroid Prime 4, right? Why are they, you know, releasing something before this? Was Next Level Games really that quickly unified and like, oh, let's just make another one of those games. We'll have it out before Metroid Prime 4. I think that that's really awesome. And of course, Metroid Prime Trilogy, that coming to the Nintendo Switch, I think is just a really good idea. A lot of people really want to still experience that whole thing. And I think that this would be a really ideal chance to do it in a console that both looks great, that also has like a mobile version of it. You can just play Metroid Prime on the go, which is going to be incredible. And it has, you know, gyro functions or motion controls and stuff like that. Even a touchscreen if you play it on the Switch handheld. So yeah, I think that generally that is really cool. I think that it would fit very well with Metroid as a franchise. I just really want more news on Metroid Prime 4. I think that all these spin-offs and different releases will get people very, you know, iffy about, wait, is that game actually coming out? And of course, they had to restart development, but I kind of want to know, is it still coming? So of course, I would love to hear what you guys think of all the news of today, you know, the entire Nintendo Direct that was, you know, rumored, like leaked. Let me know down in the comments below. If you comment down below, that could actually be featured and read out loud in our next video. And today's comment question is, what from all this news would you find interesting, and what is the next Smash character? Will it be a big surprise? And as for previous comment question winner, our answer comes to us from our user, Dangerous Army Guy, talking about those Smash Japanese code names that were in yesterday's video. If you haven't already, check that one out, it's really interesting. I think Dangan Taru Tarosu, if it translates to Bullet Tartarus, Bullet Hell, might not mean the genre called Bullet Hell. It could mean a literal hell instead. Could that be a hint to the Doomslayer appearing in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, if that is the case? He's often associated with guns and hell, after all, and many guns use bullets as ammo. Not so sure about the other ones, though, except maybe Supesu, which either could relate to the Slayer or mean something else altogether. And the Sonic game rumor that you mentioned with Amy sounds nice, but I don't think Team Sonic would be disbanded, and no reboots also. At best, I think that this would be something similar to Sonic Boom, where the game is related to a new TV series like the rumor is mentioning. But it would still be fun to play as both. Amy never really got to be playable in a main game for very long, since Adventure and Heroes, anyway. So Dangerous Army Guy, thank you so much for sending in your comment. I totally agree, there's so much Sonic stuff that could be incredible. I am waiting for my Sonic Adventure and Adventure 2 remakes for one in one pack. I think that that would be a no-brainer move. It would be incredible, and if they do it right, those games are gems, right? Super excited. So thank you so much for sending in your comment. These are always a ton of fun to read through. And of course, a huge shout out to our latest Patreon supporters. Everyone supporting this channel has been amazing in the past year, and the start of this year is no different. So thank you guys so much. And also everyone who comments on every video daily and sends me likes and, you know, different messages through Twitter and all that, it really warms my heart. So if you want to support the channel in any meaningful way, well, you can still keep watching, but also you can donate. Patreon patreon.com/blockedcontent. And remember, if you're not yet a member of the Blocked Content family yet, hit subscribe now, smash that like button, and ring the bell for notifications, and all the news and fun you care about will be delivered on the daily to you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you around the corner where there's always more Blocked Content. See ya!